like this, but don't want to pay $220. You can make it in your own garage. It's very simple. You will need polypropylene honeycomb. This is 16 millimeters. Balsa wood. Any kinds of electrical tape. Butt cap. Double sticky tape. Shoe glue. Plastic cream to cover edges. Plastic paint. Over grip tape. And some simple equipment like jigsaw and small router table. The router positioned upside down. Ready? And now it's time to cut the core using this template. This is template I just recently cut. And it matches exactly our... Okay. This is the exact shape of Yula Benjian's new panel. Now it's time to cut. Let's use a template and draw around on core. We need to use our jigsaw and cut. Now I need to run this core with the template on the top through the router to clean the edges. For this, I'm using double-sided sticky tape to attach to the core. Like this. And now let's cut it. Don't forget to wear your face protection because it's too dusty. The bearing of the router will go along the template edges, preventing cut through. And the beads will cut low part of the core. Let's do it. can remove template. And then remove the protective film from both sides. This cork has a glass epoxy finish. Now we need to sand it around to make it smooth. Next, we need to build a handle. I'm using balsa wood. Usually I use a quarter of inch thickness, but this is 1/8. The handle size is 5.5, but I usually do a little bit longer to make sure I'm overlapping the neck. So, we need to cut 5.75 inch length, two planks, balsa wood is very soft and easy to cut with your utility knife. I'm using my templates for handles plank. To cut the size I need. 1 and 2. Check the size of the handle. I prefer make it standard 4.25 inches circumference. And now balsa wood plank is not enough. We need two pieces on each side to make the handle size 4.25 or bigger. For this, I'm using double sticky tape to attach planks to each other. Thank you. the second one. Now we need to smooth edges to make 8 ribs in the paddle handle. Then we need to use sander to finish it up. I usually cut corners. Okay, the blanks are ready to attach. Okay, the handle is ready, but now you need to cut it down, I mean using sander, to the size you need. But check it out. I need a 4 1/4, and by my experience, the bare handle should be around 4 inches. But this is a little bit more. I need to sand it down. Still a bit more than 4. We got 4 inches. It's the right size. And last thing is to cover open cells of the handle. I'm using plastic strips like this to cover. It makes handle solid. Let's do it. I'm using sticky tape. Need to attach it to the handle. I left some space to make sure the edge guard will cover the neck of the pump. Now I can feel it. And the last step is secure these planks using electrical tape. Okay, the last thing is to attach the handle cap. To secure it, I'm using sticky tape at the end of the handle. Small amount of the chugu. That's it. In one layer of electric tape. Now the handle is ready and it's time to paint the surface of the bottom. Before we start painting, make sure the surface of the puddle is clean. I'm using mineral spirit. Small amount of paint every time, and I'll finish with the same black but metallic, just light touch. Okay, let's do it. I built a shelter, otherwise it would be mess around. Okay, let's paint.
for the second layer. And do it again. And the last, third layer. Okay. And the last finish, it's metallic. Very light coat. I'll show you how it looks like in the sun. Is it beautiful? Let the paddle dry for at least 20-25 minutes before attach the edge guard to the core. This is right time to check the weight. I'm going to build 8.485 ounces paddle. Before you finish with the edge guard, put it on scale at your edge guard and overgrip. It shows 8.46 ounces. This is right. Otherwise, if you need a heavy paddle, at this time you can add some weights inside of the cells. Don't do it in front, do it between handle and the third part of the paddle face, over here. Okay, let's do it. I will use sticky tape at the edges, leaving about 3-4 millimeters inside open to put some glue. Sugar. Let's do it. Before, you need to clean it. And dry. I'm using 5 mm sticky tape, but now I ran out of this one. I will use 12 mm and cut it alongside. Okay, let's cut it. Now I'm gonna cut it. Second part on the other edge of the rim. Okay, let's do the other side. See, it's about 3-4 mm open space between two sticky tape strips. It's very important to use right glue for polypropylene. There is just few glues you can use it. Don't use Gorilla glue. This glue is very hard when it dries. You need to use a glue which is flexible, because paddle will get a lot of stress when you play. That's why a lot of edge guard getting loose very quickly. Even such companies, Paddle Tech or Edge, okay, it's done. Now is the time to attach it to the paddle. First, I need to remove one cover from the double-sided sticky tape.
and warm it a little bit. Time to put some glue, just randomly. In the middle. Okay, more than enough. And then we are going to attach it to the paddle, starting from one side and going around. Use your fingers to run it along the edges like this. And then cut to the size. And do a smooth transition between the handle planks and edge guard. Okay, almost done. Make sure the edge guard is tight all around the paddle edges. And then finally secure the edge guard ends with electrical tape. Very tight.
That's it. The paddle's almost done. But it needs at least 24 hours before you can start using, because the glue requires such a time. And finally, it's time to put overgrip on the paddle handle. I will use Gemma Supreme, it's very good. Overgrip, sticky enough. First, we need to put light double-sided sticky tape to secure overgrip and prevent shifting the overgrip of the handle. I usually do it along the handle. On both sides. Okay, let's remove the cover. Okay. And put overgrip. If you're right-handed, it should be clockwise. Otherwise, it's opposite direction. Stretch a bit, go around the edge, and then go down, overlapping the previous layer, just maybe 1/3 of the width, like this. Okay, before you finish, let's cut it to the size we need. And then always, always cut diagonal. It will have a smooth transition to the end, about 4 inches length. Like this. Exactly like it was pre-cut from the other side. And finish it. Stretch more. And secure with electrical tape. I use a narrow one. Just 2 layers. One. And two. It's more than enough, but if you want, you can finish with decorative tape. Like this. That's it. The paddle's ready. We'll try it tomorrow. This is the paddle I made yesterday. It's exactly like new Ben Jones paddle. Eula. Let's try it.